Welcome back to another video. Welcome if you're new. My name is Poppy and I upload live style videos 3 times a week. So today's video is going to be a Valentine's Day gift guide. I am so excited about this video because I have so many exciting new things and new products that I've really wanted to talk to you about, and I feel like they're perfect to gift on Valentine's Day. I'm a very selfie person, so Valentine's Day is literally where I thrive. So we have things to purchase, we have things to make, and then we also have things to experience as well, so they're going to be some date night ideas. So the first section is things to purchase, and I'm so excited to share these products with you because they're brands and products I just really believe in. So the first is jewelry. Now I recently got gifted by a brand called Ana Luisa, so I'll put their Instagram on screen as well if you go and check them out, and I'll also link their link in the description bar below so that you can go and check out their website as well. But basically I got gifted a couple of pieces of jewelry and I'm obsessed with them. If I wasn't obsessed with them I wouldn't be including them in the video, so honestly they're so pretty. Even just reading about their brand, like, they seem like a really great company with really good morals. They're really into sustainability as well, and then also they make amazing jewelry. So this piece is called Rebecca, and as you can see it's basically a arty looking sun, and I absolutely love it because it's a reminder for me to look on the bright side, and literally that's probably why I can't stop touching it as well, but I absolutely love this. And then to match with this, I also got the pair of earrings that match, and honestly obsessed with these. So I haven't got them in my ears at the moment because I realised that after they'd arrived, I haven't worn earrings in so long that I need to get them re-pierced. So I'm going to do that ASAP as soon as we can when things are back to normal, because I just think this will be a really cute set to wear together. So the way I prefer to style these are literally with a sweatshirt, and what a better way to style it at the moment because we're all wearing sweatshirts anyway. But that's how I prefer to wear them. I think they'd also look really pretty with blouses as well, but this is just how I like to kind of pair them together. And then the third piece I got from Ana Luisa was another pair of earrings. Now how cute are these? So they're double hooped, absolutely gorgeous. Again, I think they could go with anything. They could go with kind of a utility style dress, they could go with loungewear, they could go with sweatshirts, jumper. I just feel like they're a very versatile piece, so that's one thing I'd say about all of their jewelry. You can really just pair it with anything. All of their pieces are created with clean, low impact and recycled materials where possible, so I just think that's a really nice bonus. So if you are looking to treat yourself or you're looking to treat somebody else to a beautiful piece of jewelry, then at the moment would be the perfect time because they're running a Valentine's Day promotion across everything on their website, and there's a huge 15% off, which really makes a difference as well. There's a huge 15% off every single item on their website, and that's running up until the 15th of February, so definitely go and check them out. As I said, I will leave a link in the description bar below. Now moving on to the next thing to purchase, skincare. I am obsessed with skincare. I feel like this obsession, like many of us, has come because of lockdown, and we just have so much more time, luckily, to spend and invest on ourselves and just spend time in general just practicing self-care. And I absolutely love Balance Me. So Balance Me, they do these natural scented products, and honestly they're so incredible. Everything I've used from Balance Me, their products are just so soft and they work so well for my skin. The two things that I wanted to mention that I think would be really nice gifts just to either treat yourself to or again to treat somebody else to would be the Balance Me Moisture Rich Face Cream. So that's this face cream from Balance Me. It's so soft, it's so kind to your skin. Also, it has this incredible rose scented smell as well, so it kind of lifts your mood, and that's what I love about everything from Balance Me, is that all of the scents they have are just so relaxing, and it just enhances your mood. So yeah, absolutely love this. It's so soft. You really don't need to use a lot as well, and I use this either in the morning or the evening, or sometimes during the day as well when I actually just want to practice some self-care. That's one thing I love about Balance Me as well, is that their motto is skincare is self-care, and that you should spend 5 minutes a day just practicing skincare for some self-care. And I totally agree. I think it's such a relaxing activity. It's probably one of the most relaxing activities you can do for self-care, so I think that would be an amazing gift to treat yourself to. The next thing is the Balance Me PHA Clarifying Mist, and that's this. It's so incredible. So basically, it's a face mist that you literally just spray on your face. You can use it for primer, you can use it to kind of set your makeup as well after you've done your makeup. You could have it on your bedside table, and when you wake up in the morning, just spritz some of this on to wake you up. And honestly, this smells incredible. It kind of reminds me of like eucalyptus. I don't know if that's how it's meant to set, smell, but that's what it reminds me of, and honestly, it's just so relaxing. I'd say this is probably their most relaxing product that I have tried, and I've got so many things from Balance Me skincare, so I would definitely recommend this. I think it's just a really nice thing to have kind of in your bag. If you're feeling a bit stressed, spritz them on and it will literally calm you right down, or just in a self-care routine, a morning routine, an evening routine. Definitely recommend this. Absolutely love this face mist. Moving on to the next product to purchase, I would say perfume is kind of a go-to safe gift. And do you know what? It's one of those gifts that is literally timeless. People are always going to appreciate some perfume. But I want to kind of put a little bit of a twist on this. So this is something I was gifted from my mum for Christmas, actually. And it's some hair perfume. Now, this smells incredible. So I'm going to link it down below, and I really hope that I don't butcher the brand's name. But it's called Dipsy Q Paris. And this is the box that came in. It's so, so pretty. And then this is the bottle that it came in. And honestly, it smells incredible. Honestly, it's on another level. I love how it smells. And what I love about this is you literally just spritz some after you've done your hair onto your hair. And basically with perfume, I find it's quite touch and go whether other people can smell it, especially if you're not outside and you're kind of indoors. I feel like you need some kind of airflow to be able to smell it. With this, I mean, we move our hair naturally anyway, so other people can just smell it around you, and it smells incredible. So I'll link this down below. I'll ask my mum if she can forward me the link, because this smells absolutely incredible. I'd definitely recommend. The next thing to purchase, I'd say, is home decor. Now, I feel like home decor is an amazing thing to treat yourself to anyway, but this year and last year, literally, we are all at home constantly. We're spending all of our time at home, so why not? I feel like home decor would be the perfect gift. And you can probably guess what I'm gonna tell if you've been here before. Candles. I feel like candles are just that kind of romantic twist on home decor, or they're just really relaxing as well to have. So a scented candle. I'm going to show you this wildflower white anemone. I'm not really sure how you pronounce that, but it smells absolutely incredible. And I love this because it has this like little technicolor glass. I'll have to ask Reese's mum where she got this from, so I can try and link this for you, because this is the prettiest jar I have ever seen on a candle, literally. But yeah, this smells absolutely incredible. And then I also have one for a man as well. So this is something that my parents actually gifted to Reese for Christmas, and they're milocandles.com. This smells literally like a men's fragrance, but it's just so much nicer than that. It's so, so good. So I would definitely say, I mean, if you're into that kind of scent anyway, then you can gift yourself this, but this would be a really, really good present for a man as well. So definitely recommend. Oh my goodness, I literally cannot stop smelling candles when they're in front of me. And then the next one as well is from the same brand, so milocandles.com, and this one's called Main Street Coffee Fresh Roasted Daily Soy Wax Candle. So this is the Main Street Coffee one, and this smells so, so good as well. Oh my goodness, honestly, I love the smell of coffee anyway, so coffee and a scented candle, perfect combination. So I'll leave the links for these in the description bar below, as well as with everything else, so I can stop saying that. So that brings us on to the next section of the video. So we've looked at all the things that you can purchase that I wanted to recommend, and now it's the things that you can make. This is one of my favorite parts of Valentine's Day, is literally just getting creative and just putting lots of thoughts into a gift. I feel like gifts don't need to be expensive or lavish. I mean, if you want to do that, totally, you know, do what you're comfortable with, do what you like. But for me, I really, really love it when somebody's put some thought into a gift. So I feel like anything homemade can just be a really lovely gift to have. So I have some suggestions for things that you could homemake. And my first one, I'm just looking down at my notes, is a painting. So this is something I wouldn't have thought of actually, because I'm one of six, and I come from a family full of creative people, but I just do not have the talent to be able to paint or draw. Like, I just do not have that talent at all. If you're really creative, if you're really into your art, if you're able to use things like Canva really well and just create some nice abstract art, then I think that would be really, really fun to do, is just to create a piece of art or a painting or a sketch, anything that you can do, and just frame it and give that to somebody. I think that'd be a really, really cute gift. So I'll put one on screen now that my sister's been doing, if she lets me. If not, I'll just put some suggestions of ones that I really like as well. Because I think, yeah, she's done an amazing job. She's a really arty person. I am one of six and literally come from the most creative household ever. But that just skipped me. I'm not able to draw anything, paint anything. It would just be a shambles. But yeah, she's done a really good job on hers, and I just think abstract art, I absolutely love that kind of art, so I think that could be a really good gift as well. Moving on to the next one is baked goods. Now this is perfect. I feel like so many of us have explored our baking or cooking side whilst we've been in lockdown. I certainly have. If you've watched any of my other vlogs, usually there were baked treats, but because it's the new year, I'm trying to rein it in just a little bit. But I think baked goods can be a really lovely thing as well, a lovely sweet treat. And you can find ones that look quite Valentine's-y. So you could make some pink cupcakes, you could make some brownies with some pink sprinkles on them. I think that's something I'm going to do to contribute to our Valentine's Day evening. So yeah, I think that's a really sweet idea as well. You can wrap them up in some tissue paper in a cute little tin, drop them off. You could even do doorstop drop-offs for your friends or for your family if you're anywhere near them as well. So I think that could be a really cute idea too. So if your creativity is more swayed less towards baking, less towards art, and more towards media, then a couple of things you'd be able to do is maybe sing a cover of a song for somebody, record a cover, write a song for someone, or you could also do maybe like a little video collage. That'd be really, really cute as well, of all of your favorite photos and memories with that person. So I think just those additional thoughtful things can just really make somebody's Valentine's Day or Valentine's week. So I think they're lovely gifts, and I would be so, so happy to receive anything thoughtful like that. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, then be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe down below as well, so you don't miss out on the next video. Thanks so much for watching, and hopefully I'll chat to you in the comments. Bye!